बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल ताइफ वर्चुअल लर्निंग सिस्टम। टुडे इज़ आवर 29th वीडियो लेक्चर फॉर 7th स्टूडेंट्स। आई एम मिसेस रोजिया इमरान, योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। टुडे वी विल स्टडी एक्सरसाइज 8.6 एंड 8.7। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडी अबाउट 8.5 and 8.4. 8.4 was simple multiplication of the algebraic terms, and we simply multiply two brackets and solve it. And in 8.5 we study three formula. One formula is x plus a into x plus b, so that will be x square plus bracket a plus b into x plus a multiply b. This was the first formula which we study when we have two brackets and the first values are, that is the binomial identity. So when the first values are same and the second value different, so you will use this formula. Second formula which we study, that was the two terms whole square, means that a plus b whole square, which is a square plus 2ab plus b square. And the third formula which we study, that was when we have two terms and when we have two brackets having same value, one having plus sign and one having minus sign. So how can you solve? A plus b into a minus b, that will be a square minus b square. These formulas we also use in exercise 8.7 and exercise 8.6. Some formulas we use. So you must memorize these formula and repeat it again and again. Now come to question number 1, exercise 8.6, resolve into factors, means that you factorize the algebraic term. Here you have given the first part 5x square y minus 10xy square. So how can we resolve into factor? We check the common value in this. Look, first you check the coefficient. Here you have 5 and here you have 10. So both are divisible by 5, so you take 5 common and then you check the variable. Here x 2 times, here x 1 times. So maximum 1 time x you can take common, and here y 1 time and here y 2 times. So y you can take common. So what you can take common? 5xy. When you take 5xy common, look, from the first value you take 5 common. So coefficient is 1, 5 divided by 5, 1. And then x square, x 2 times, 1 time you take common, 1 time is left. Y is only 1 time you take it common, so only x is left. Then minus sign as it is. Then 10 divided by 5, so 5 2s are 10. X you already take common, y 2 times given, 1 time you take common, 1 time is left. So this is the required solution. Very easy. You will just take common the variable and the coefficient. Now come to the second part. In second part you have given 2a minus 4b plus 6c. If you check in this question, all the variables are different from each other. The variables are different from each other, so we can't take the variable common. So only the coefficient you can check it. All coefficient are divisible by 2, so only 2 you can take common. So you take 2 common, so 2 divided by 2, 1, coefficient is 1a, and minus 4 divided by 2, 2b, plus 6 divided by 2, 2 3s are 6, 3c. So this is the required answer. So resolve into factor, when you have two values or three values, you check the coefficient and the variable. If there is common, so you take it common. Now you have given, third part is your homework. In third part, students, only three you will take common, so you can easily solve it. I give you hint. The three you take common, so it will be easily solved. Now a cube b plus a square b plus ab cube. Here you check the first variable a. Here 3 times given, here 2 times given, here 1 time. So maximum 1 time you can take common. Similarly, b is here 3 times, here 2 times, here 1 time. So ab you can take common, ab. A 2, 3 times present, 1 time take common, so 2 times left. B 1 time present, 1 time you take common. Here a 2 times b 2 times 1 time a b you take common, a b is left, and here a 1 time you already take it common, b 3 times, so 1 time you take common, 2 times left. So this is the fourth part, very easy question. Now come to question number 2, factorize by using identity. When you have a question that factorize by using identity means that you have to solve it by using formula. Now look at the question, and from question you will identify that which one formula we use. Look, if you check here, you have two terms. The first term is a perfect square. This is perfect square of 2a. Look, 4 is a perfect square of 2. 2 2's a 4. A is a perfect square. A square is a perfect square of a. So means that 2a whole square. And 25 is a perfect square of b. So means that 25 is a perfect square of 5, so 5 square. And in between them, negative sign. So the third formula which we studied in previous lecture, that was a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So look, here a is 2a whole square minus b is 5 whole square. When, remember one thing, when you have two terms and both are perfect square and in between them minus sign, so which one formula you will use? A square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So a is 2a and b is 5. So this one formula, a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. In previous lecture, we have given the question in this form, a plus b into a minus b, we convert it into a square minus b square. Now in this exercise, you have given the inverse form. In a square minus b square form given, you will convert it in this. So a is the first term 2a, so 2a plus 5 into 2a minus 5. Like this, you have to solve. Now come to the next question, 4x square minus 9y square. Again, two terms, both are perfect square, in between them minus sign. 4 is a perfect square of 2, so 2x whole square. 9 is a perfect square of 3, so 3y whole square. 2x whole square minus 3y whole square. Again, a square minus b square formula, a plus b into a minus b, this formula. So 2x plus 3y into 2x minus 3y. Very easy. Now come to the third part. Third part is 9a square minus b square. Again, it is a perfect square. Both values are perfect square. In between them, minus sign. So again, formula a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So here, 3a whole square minus b whole square. So which one formula? A square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So 3a plus b into 3a minus b. Fourth part is your homework, so you will try it by yourself. Fourth part is 9m square minus 16n square. So 9 is a perfect square of 3, so 3m whole square, and 16 is a perfect square of 4. So 3m whole square minus 4n whole square. Okay, so you try it by yourself. Now come to the next exercise, exercise 8.7. again, you have given resolve into factor by using identity, means that you use formula, you solve. When you have question that using identity, so you should solve it with formula. If you will not solve with formula, you will get no marks. Here x square plus 8x plus 16. So three terms. So recall the formulas, the three formulas which we studied. One was the a square minus b square, which we discussed in previous lecture. So this one was not applicable because in that we have two terms, both are perfect square minus sign. And next, the other formula which we studied, that was a plus b whole square, which is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, means three terms. Now check. A square, yes, x square. B square, yes, 16 is the perfect square of 4. 2ab, 2, a is x, b is 4. So 4 2's are 8. Yes, this one formula we will use. Look, x whole square, 16 is the perfect square of 4. 4 whole square, a first term square, last term square and plus 2 into first term into last term. So x into 4, 4, 2 is 8. Again we get. So this one formula. Look, in previous question, it was given like this. Two terms having whole square. So we open it. A square plus 2ab plus b square. Now it is given in open form. We close it. A plus b whole square. Look, a square plus 2ab plus b square. So it will be equal to a plus b whole square. A is x plus b is 4 plus 4 whole square. So x plus 4 whole square. Come to the second part, x square minus 2x plus 1. Again, the first term is a perfect square of x. The last term 1 is a perfect square of itself. X whole square plus 1 whole square. This is minus 2x. Wait, I'll make it correct. So if having minus sign, so it will be minus, and here the formula will change. Two terms minus, and this will be a minus b. This is the third formula, fourth formula. A square minus 2ab plus b square, a minus b whole square. Remember one thing, both are same. When you have both values plus sign having whole square, so same, but here with 2ab plus sign. But if it is the middle term minus, so here a minus b whole square. So the first term square, yeah, first term square minus sign, last term square minus 2ab. 2, first term is x, second term is 1. So 2x, and the formula which we use, a square minus 2ab plus b square, which is equal to a minus b whole square. This is the fourth one formula. So x minus 1, a minus b whole square. So x minus 1 whole square. Next part, third, is a power 4 minus 4a square plus 49. A power 4 is the perfect square of a square. 49 is the perfect square of 7. So a square whole square and 7 whole square minus sign as it is 2ab. A is a square, b is 7. Look, 7 2 is a 14. Again we get. So which one formula? A square minus 2ab plus b square, which is equal to a minus b whole square. So a is a square minus sign, b is 7, 7 whole square. The fourth part, 1 is a perfect square of itself, 25 is a perfect square of 5. So we write it 1 square plus 2 into first term into second term plus second term square. So which one formula? Again, a square plus 2ab plus b square, which is equal to a plus b whole square. So a is 1 and b is 5m. So 1 plus 5m whole square. So this was the answer. Now come to the next question. No homework in exercise 8.7, question number 1. Factorize by using identity. Again, you are going to use formula. With the help of formula, you have to solve. Three terms means the same formula which we study. If you check, the first term is a perfect square of AX. Is it? And the last term is a perfect square of BC. And middle is 2, the first term into second term. Look, AX whole square plus BC whole square plus 2 into AX into BC. Again, we get the middle term. So which one formula is A square plus 2AB plus B square, which is equal to A plus B whole square. So here A is AX, B is BC. So AX plus BC whole square. Second part is, again, the first term is a perfect square. How? L square is a perfect square of L. 4 is a perfect square of 2. So L over 2 whole square. And here MN is a perfect square of MN whole square. So L over 2 whole square plus MN whole square plus 2AB. 2, A is L over 2 and B is MN. So 2 to cancel. So we get LMN, the middle term. So a square plus 2ab plus b square. So a plus b whole square. So a is l over 2 and b is mn. So l over 2 plus mn whole square. L over 2. Oh, this is l over. This is l over 2. L over 2 plus mn whole square. L over 2 plus mn whole square. Third part is 4 over 9 x square minus xy plus 9 over 16 y square. Look, 4 is the perfect square of 2. 9 is the perfect square of 3. 3 threes are 9, 2 twos are 4. So 2 over 3 x whole square. And here 3 over 4. 16 is the perfect square of 4. 3 over 4 whole square. 3 over 4 y whole square. So we have to use this formula here, negative sign. So a square minus 2ab plus b square, which is a minus b whole square. So first term 2 over 3x whole square. Last term 3 over 4y whole square. So minus 2 into 2 over 3x, 3 over 4y. Look, 3 cancel with 3. 2 twos are 4. 4 cancel with 4. So we get minus xy. So it will be equal to the first term minus last term whole square. So 2 over 3x minus 3 over 4y whole square. So this is the required answer. And the fourth part is your homework. Now this is your homework exercise 8.6, question number 1 third part, and question number 2 fourth part, and exercise 8.7, question number 2 fourth part is your homework. Now again, I'm going to repeat one time the things which we study today. Resolve into factors means that you have to factorize it. For factorization, we take common. So here 5 coefficient is common because 5 is divisible by 5 and 10. XY is common. X here 2 times, here 1 time. So only 1 time you can take common. Y 1 time you can take common. 5XY you take common. So coefficient 1 is left and here x only left. 5 2s are 10. X you already take common. Y 2 times, 1 time you take common, 1 time left. So this is the required answer. 2a minus 4b plus 6c. Variables are different from each other. So only the variable 2 you can take common. Sorry, the coefficient 2 you can take common. So a 2 2s are 4, 2b plus 2 3s are 6, 3c. This you get. A cube b plus a square b plus a b cube. If you check, a is maximum, you can take it common one time because here 2 times, here 3 times, but here 1 time. So a you take common. Similarly, b here 1 time, here 2 times. So a b you can take common. When you take a b common, a left 2 times here, and here a b 1 time you take common, 1 time left. A you already take common, b 3 times present. So 1 time you take common and 2 times present. Next question, factorize by using identity. Remember one thing, when you have two terms, both are perfect square. Perfect square means that when you, how you check that it is a perfect square or not, if it is a big number. So what will you do? 4 under root with your calculator, the square root sign. Square root sign, you click, 4 click and check, you will get that it is a perfect square of 2. Similarly, 25 square root, it is a perfect square of 5. So how can you know that it is a perfect square of which number? By taking square root. So 2a whole square and minus 5 whole square. So this is the formula, a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So 2a whole square minus 5 whole square, this formula, a plus b into a minus b. So a is 2a and b is 5. So 2a plus b and 2a, 2a plus 5 and 2a minus 5. Similarly, 4x square is a perfect square of 2x and 9y is a perfect square of 3y. So that will be 2x plus 3y and 2x minus 3y. This formula you will use, 2x plus 3y and 2x minus 3y. 9a square minus b square, 9a square is a perfect square of 3a and b square is a perfect square of b. So formula 3a plus b into 3a minus b. This one formula you will use, 3a plus b and 3a minus b. Formula will not be given in the question. You will identify it from the question statement. Now, exercise 8.7, resolve into factor by using identity means that you have to use formula. Three terms, so means that a square minus b square formula you can't use. Now you check, the first term is a perfect square, last term is a perfect square. So middle term should be 2ab. So this is x square and this is 4 square. So 2a is x, 2 into x into 4. 4 2's are 8, 8x you get. Yes, this one formula, which one? A plus b whole square, which is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, a plus b whole square. So here a is x, b is 4, so x plus 4 whole square. Similarly, x square minus 2, then the same formula. If here you have negative sign, so a minus b whole square it will be. X square, 1 square minus 2 into x into 1, so x minus 1, x minus 1 whole square. Come to the third part, A4 is a perfect square of A square, 49 is a perfect square of 7. So minus 2AB, A is A square and B is 7, 7 2's are 14 A square. Again you get, so you will use A square minus 2AB plus B square, which is A minus B whole square. So A is A square and B is 7, so A square minus 7 whole square. Fourth part is 1 is a perfect square of 1 and 25 is a perfect square of 5. So 5m. 1 square, 5m square plus 2ab, a is 1 and b is 5m. So this one formula you will use, a square plus 2ab plus b square. So a is 1 and b is 5m. So 1 plus 5m whole square. Next, factorize by using identity. Same formula which we study in previous question. First term is a perfect square of ax, last term is a perfect square of bc. So ax whole square, bc whole square plus 2ab. Ab is ax, b is bc. So you use this formula, a square plus 2ab plus b square, which is equal to a plus b whole square. So a is ax and b is bc. So ax plus bc whole square. Next question, L square over 4. So L square over 4 is a perfect square of L over 2. M square N square is a perfect square of MN. So L over 2 whole square and MN whole square plus 2 into the first term L over 2, the second term MN. So this formula is A square plus 2AB plus B square. A plus B whole square, so L over 2 plus mn whole square is the answer. Come to the third part. Third part is 4 over 9 x square minus xy plus 9 over 16 y square. So 4 over 9 is a perfect square over 2 over 3 x whole square. And this is 3 over 4 y whole square. 2 over 3 x whole square, 3 over 4 y square minus sign 2ab. A is 2 over 3 x, b is 3 over 4 y. Look, when we solve, 3 cancel with 3, 2 2's are 4, 4 cancel with 4. So you get xy minus xy this. So a is 2 over 3 x, b is 3 over 4 y. So 2 over 3 x minus 3 over 4 y whole square, and this is your homework. So I hope you will understand it. I explain again and again, and so these are very important. Try to solve it, try to practice the question which are not included in your syllabus. Try to practice these question, these exercise, because you will use this concept inshallah in class 8th and 9th and 10th, so on. So algebra is very important. Try to do it by yourself, the remaining parts which are given in homework, and for practice, do those questions which are not included in your syllabus and check the answer from the back to check yourself that you know the formula or not. Okay, take care. Allah Hafiz.